Good morning, dear children. Welcome back to science class. Today, we discuss about the remaining portion of lesson 2, air and water. In the previous session, we discussed about air, composition of air, properties of air, and how can we keep air clean. Similarly, air, water is also essential for our survival. 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with water. Can you imagine your life without water? Without water, there is no life existing on earth. Water is a colorless liquid, and water is also tasteless and odorless. Water is essential for all living beings. Many things dissolved in water. So, it is called a universal solvent. Water exists in 3 states: solid, liquid, and gas. Water exists in 3 states: solid, liquid, and gas. Next, we discuss about impurities in water. Water that we get is not pure. It contains many impurities. Impurities can be soluble or insoluble. When impurities dissolve completely, they are said to be soluble. Impurities that do not dissolve are said to be insoluble. Impure water also contains disease-causing germs. Drinking impure water can make us sick. Therefore, we must remove the impurities from water. Boiling is the safest method of water purification. Boiling kills germs. There are different ways of removing different types of impurities. Children, how we can remove soluble impurities in water? Evaporation. Water when heated turns into water vapor. This is called evaporation. Next, we discuss about removing insoluble impurities in water. First one, sedimentation. Water present in nature often contains insoluble impurities like soil particles, ticks, and animal excreta, which make it unclean and unfit for use. Sedimentation is a method of removing such impurities in an easy manner. If the mixture of soil and water is stirred and left undisturbed for a few hours, then the soil particles start settling down slowly at the bottom of the vessel. It is only when the water is clear that the process of sedimentation is complete. The solid impurities that settle down at the bottom of the vessel are called the sediments. The second method of removing insoluble impurities from water is filtration. The simplest example of this method of removing insoluble impurities is when we string tea into a cup using a tea strainer. Filtration is the physical process of separating insoluble substances from liquids using fine cloth, filter paper, plastic or steel strainer. Liquid containing insoluble impurities is poured into a funnel lined on the inside with a filter paper or fine cloth.
The clean water passes through the filter, leaving all the insoluble impurities behind, and is collected in a jar kept below the funnel. The filtered water does not contain any insoluble impurities. The insoluble impurities left on the filter paper is called residue. Boiling the filtrate kills the microscopic impurities in it, such as germs and microbes. Okay, my dear children, let's wind up today's class. I think you all understood today's topic. Water, impurities in water, removing soluble impurities and removing insoluble impurities in water. So, study well. See you on next class. Take care. Thank you.